Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about Claviceps purpurea. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding about the mycelium of Claviceps, asexual reproduction, formation and germination of Sclerotium, sexual reproduction, and finally, its life cycle. Let us begin with the introduction to Claviceps purpurea. Claviceps purpurea is a phytopathogenic fungus which parasitizes grasses and cereals. It infects the young gynoecium or unfertilized ovaries, causing a disease known as ergot. It replaces the seed by dark mycelial masses known as sclerotia. The alkaloid ergotin present in sclerotia can cause severe intoxication in mammals. Let us get an idea about the mycelium of Claviceps purpurea. The infection occurs at the flowering stage. The ascospores are dispersed by wind. Both the stigma and ovary wall are the sites of infection. The ascospores settle on the feathery stigma or directly on the ovary. They germinate and give rise to a number of germ tubes which penetrate the wall of the ovary. The germ tubes branch profusely to form the mycelium, which is white, haline, septate, branched, and multinucleated. The plasma membrane of the cells encloses the granular cytoplasm containing mitochondria, vesicles, and a number of nuclei. These mycelia finally destroy the ovule. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share this video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us study about the asexual reproduction in Claviceps purpurea. Certain hyphae from the mycelial mat rupture the cuticle of the ovary and produce a compact palisade-like layer of conidiophores. At the tip, each conidiophore bears extremely small haline uninucleate, spherical or ovate, spore-like structures called conidia. This is known as the spacelial stage or honeydew stage. The conidia accumulate in a sticky, dense, yellow, sugary fluid. The sugary fluid, as it exudates and oozes out from the florets, it carries along with it a number of conidia. The honeydew attracts insects. Insects transfer the conidia to other healthy flowers, and the disease quickly spreads. Next, let us understand the formation and germination of sclerotia. The hyphae of the spacelial mycelium forms a compact, dense, dark-colored mass of hard pseudoparenchymatous tissue at the base of the ovary. It is known as the sclerotium or ergot grain, which lies between the glumes of the spikelet. The mature sclerotium has a central white portion surrounded by a thick outer protective coat to tide over the unfavorable conditions that prevail in winter. Some sclerotia are harvested together with the grains, while others fall on the ground. They remain in the soil during winter. Sclerotium germinates to form several fruiting bodies with slender stalk or stipe bearing spherical or capitulate head. Next, let us study about the sexual reproduction in Claviceps purpurea. Each head consists of a number of small, flash-shaped cavities arranged in a peripheral layer containing the sex organs. The male antheridia and the female archegonia develop in the periphery. Sexual reproduction involves fusion of the cytoplasm of female ascogonia and male antheridia, known as plasmogamy. There is no fusion of nuclei at this stage. Therefore, it results in the formation of dikaryotic ascogenous hyphae. During favorable condition, the fruiting bodies perithecia develop, followed by karyogamy or fusion of the two nuclei. Division by meiosis and mitosis results in the formation of 8 haploid nuclei. Each uninucleate protoplast gets surrounded by a wall and develops into mature ascospores. During moist condition, spores continue the life cycle. Finally, let us look into the life cycle of Claviceps purpurea. Life cycle of Claviceps purpurea starts when the ascospores are dispersed by wind and they fall on the feathery stigma of grasses in spring. The fungal mycelium spreads and destroys the ovary of the plant. It manifests into spatial producing sugary honeydew containing asexual spores. Conidia, which are dispersed by insects, later gets converted into sclerotium. When a mature sclerotium falls on the ground, it remains dormant during winter. In the following spring, it germinates into fruiting bodies with head and stipe. In the head, ascospores are formed within the perithecia. When the spores are ejected, they infect other plants. So today, we have learnt in detail about the life cycle of Claviceps purpurea. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comment section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.